any debris away from her toenails and cuticles, cleaning any debris away from the bottom of the toenails. That way, I can get a feel of the bottom of her toenails and I can see if there's any visible cracks, anything like that. And what I'm feeling for are holes, cracks, any rocks that could be lodged in the toenail, anything like that. I'm also checking to make sure that this toenail has not overgrown downwards. Because these toenails do grow downwards, we don't want it to grow past the pad of the foot. Because we want them to walk on the pad of their foot, not the tips of their toes. They put a lot of pressure on the joints of these metacarpals through here. So, we'll take the rough side of our hip rest, lightly lift those up, make sure the edges are nice and rounded off. Make sure to go in between the toes as well. Because if these toenails are touching, they'll rub while she walks or while she stands, they'll press together and that constant pressure is going to be uncomfortable. It's all about making a little contact. We'll take our hoof knife, drag all these cuticles, make sure there's no excess cuticle there. And if there is, we can trim it all off. And this is a very important part because elephants only sweat through their cuticles. The skin up here is so thick, even if she had sweat glands up here, sweat wouldn't be able to escape. So, without that sweat, this toenail is going to dry out, it's going to become brittle, cracked, it could even fall off. So, need that moisture to keep this toenail pliable and strong. All right, television. And because we asked her to do something special, of course, she's going to get a treat. Elephants are very food motivated, so anytime we ask her to do anything special, a treat we appreciate.
Come here, she's around.
How often do you have to give her a pedicure?
Once every 2 weeks. And Wendy, 3-4 times a month. So it all just depends on the elephant. Because some, like Wendy, has really fast-growing cuticles. Kilrea moves around a lot, so you really don't have to worry too much about her feet. Yeah. I'm short, and this is a talk with people, but we'll take, if you lean some of that sand away. Now, we do take care of these four toes the same way we take care of the front five toes. But now you can see the pad kind of. Y'all are way over there. But now you can kind of see the pad. See all these grooves here? These are for traction. Very important that we keep these clean, free of debris. We don't want any rocks getting lodged in there. Because if a rock gets lodged in there, over time it's going to work its way through the pad of the foot and into the actual foot where it can cause an abscess. And that's not going to be very pleasant. So, we just make sure we drag this. An abscess is an infection. Yeah, the number one cause of death in the wild, natural death, is foot-related injuries. So an abscess in the wild couldn't mean death.
Are they ticklish?
Apparently not.
No. No, that's right. So this is just a thing now. She can barely feel pressure. But she can feel a fly land on her skin up here. And that's because of the hair follicles. The hair follicles penetrate deep into the skin. And these hairs, if a fly lands in there, touches those hairs, she's going to feel it. But because they migrate for 16 hours a day in the wild, they naturally wear down these feet. But here, they don't have to. They can be lazy. We bring them food. We bring them water. So we have to take care of their feet as well. Yeah, we'll just take the rough side of our hoof rasp. Make sure there's no abnormally high squats. Make sure there's no rocks. Make sure these are all opened up so that she can bring your foot over here. There we go. I'm short. Come on now. But just make sure that's nice and worn down. We keep it about 3/8 of an inch to a half inch thick, because that's about where it is naturally in the wall. All right, over here. But I'm sure y'all saw footprints in the gift shop. We're going to show you how we make those footprints.